Hello and welcome to this Swift tutorial. In this video, we are going to be taking a look at how to create a video player. So a lot of you guys requested this, and that's why I'm making this. So a video player, as the name implies, is all about creating a video player and displaying a video inside of your app. And of course, you're going to have all the normal controls, play, pause, shut down the video player, and all that good stuff. So that's what we are going to be taking a look at in this video. So if that is something you are interested in learning how to do, then just keep watching this video and we will be taking a look at it together right now. Okay, so let's go ahead and find Xcode and we're going to create a new project. So let's double tap here and I'm going to make this a single view application. Click next and I'm just going to name it video player. Make sure that the language is set to Swift and then just save your newly created project. Now what we're going to do is I'm first of all going to encourage you to find a video. Now I would make it a short video because that will take the minimum amount of space, but of course you can make it however long you want. I've just chosen a 18 second clip right here of me saying something. And of course, if you want access to this video, then you can just access it through the link in the description where I have the project files linked. But I'm just going to use this video and I'm going to drag it into my Xcode project. But first of all, I'm going to locate where I'm going to drag it to. And I'm going to go just here, an overview over my project, and I'm going to head over to build phases. Then I'm going to locate something that's called copy bundle resources, expand on that one, and then just drag it straight in there, just like this. Finish, and that is going to do for now. So here we have our video saved in our right here. And then we are going to get to the fun stuff, which is accessing this video and then playing it. Now, in order to do that, we first of all have to import something. And this is going to be our AVKit, so audio and video kit, which is going to allow us to work with audio and video. But in this case, we're just going to work with video, but still we are going to need it. Then I'm actually going to head over to my storyboard. And then I'm going to drag in a button there because I want a nice button to be displayed. And then when the user taps on that button, then I want to display the video. So I'm just going to write here, watch video, press here to watch video. I'm going to give it a background color equal to blue. And I'm going to give it some white text so that we can read what the button says, just like that, center it in the view controller. Just like that. And now we can bring up our split view just to connect our button so that we have access to it. So just select the button, hold down control and drag it over. And I'm just going to call it the button action, make it an action and connect. Awesome. So now let's head over to our view controller so that we get some more space and we can start coding. Now, the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to get the URL to our resource because as you remember, we dragged in the video and we placed it inside our project. Now we want the path or the URL to that project. And the way we get that, if we use a if let statement, and I'm going to name this constant path, and I'm going to try to access or get the path of my resource. The way I do that is I simply say bundle dot main because that is where it's contained within, and then I'm going to get the exact path by saying path for resource, and the resource name is video because that's what I called my file. And then you have to make sure that you check the file extension. As you can see, you can also view it up here, and it's video.mp4, so just write mp4 just like that. Okay, so here we have our if statement, and if that's successful, then we are going to continue. Now what we want to do is we want to take the content that is contained at that URL and store it in a video constant, so that we have our video stored, or so that we're able to access it via a constant. And this constant I'm going to name video, and this is going to be an AV player, and it's going to be based on the URL. Let's see, and one more time, URL, and then we are simply going to type in file path. Let's see if I've done everything correctly here. File path, file URL with path, file URL with path. I'm just going to have to type it out here, path. Let's see if this is going to work, and I think that looks great, and it doesn't look like Xcode has a problem with it. So let's just continue. Basically what we're doing here is we're accessing the video. So here we get the URL to the video, and here we're accessing the video itself. Now that we have the video, we need something to play the video with. And in order to do that, we create a video player. So let video player is equal to AV player view controller. So now we have the video and we have our video player. And the only step left now for this time being is to say to the video player that the video it's going to play is going to be our constant named video. So we're basically saying this video player here should play this video right here. And now it does that, but of course our user can't see it yet. So that's why we need to present our video player. And we do that by saying present. And the view controller we want to present is our video player. Animated, true. And we are going to need a completion handler. So let's double tap here. And in here, I'm just going to write video, let's see, not video player, but video.play. So basically, again, what we're doing here is we are presenting our video player that contains our video. And then after it has been presented to the user, we play the video. Now let's see if this works as we want it to work. And I really think it is going to work. But let's see, let's launch our project and see that everything works. Okay, so here is our application. And let's try to do what the button says, which is to press here. I'm going to tap it. And we should now see a video that is playing. So as you can see, it works. This was a sneak preview of my face detection tutorial out on my YouTube channel. There was a plug. But other than that, it works. And as you can see, you got all the controls that you normally would. You have the audio control, you have the play pause button, and of course you can also shut down the video player in order to return, and you can press it again as many times as you want. So that is how you create a video controller. Some of you requested this, so here it was. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Take care. So that was it for this video today. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope that you thoroughly enjoyed this video. If you did, then make sure to leave a like and press the subscribe button. And as always, you can also find me on Facebook and Twitter if you got that sort of stuff. Now again, thank you for watching and take care, and I hope to see you back in the next one.